Start with a new chapter. We have already done two chapters related to reproduction. Today we are going to start with the third chapter in this unit, that is human reproduction. Is it okay? So very quick, let's start human reproduction. See, we know are sexually reproducing viviparous organisms. Everybody knows the meaning of viviparous, so I'm not taking up. Humans are sexually reproducing viviparous organisms. They're also unisexual. When I say unisexual, I mean male and female. They have their own separate gonads. The word gonads, G-O-N-A-D-S, we've been studying it since many classes. What do I mean by gonads? I mean the reproductive organs. G-O-N-A-D-S, gonads. So wherever the word gonad is used, I'm talking about the reproductive organs. Let's move on to reproductive system. See, we know human beings, they show sexual dimorphism. We say human beings show sexual dimorphism, that means the males and the female differ in primary and secondary sex characteristics. When I say primary and secondary sex characteristics, we should know the difference between both of them. Primary sex characteristics are those which are present since birth, whether in a male or in a female. Some characteristics are present since birth. Such characteristics are known as primary sex characteristics. And what are secondary sex characteristics? Some characteristics which are acquired after puberty or at the age of puberty are what we call as the secondary sexual characteristics. Similarly, reproductive organs are also divided as primary sex organs and secondary sex organs. So, what are primary sex organs? Those organs which produce gametes and sex hormones. Those organs which produce gametes and sex hormones, they are called as primary sex organs. And what about secondary sex organs? They do not produce gametes, they do not even produce sex hormones, but they play a very important role during sexual reproduction, so we call them as reproductive organs. So primary sex organs and secondary sex organs. Today we are going to take up the male reproductive system, the primary organs of course. See, when we say about male reproductive system, it is located in the pelvic region. You know this, it consists of the following organs. We are going to study about the three main primary organs. The first is testes. It is a primary sex organ in males, we know this, and they are also the male gonads. Why are they the male gonads? Because they are the male reproductive organs. Now, let us move ahead. Now, this is the site. Testis is the site where male gametes, that is sperms, are produced in males. That is why we consider them as the male gonads, because the male gametes, that is sperms, they are produced in the testis. A pair of testis is situated, you know where, outside the abdominal cavity, within the scrotum. Each testis is oval in shape, around 4 to 5 cm in length and 2 to 3 cm in width. The testis are suspended in the scrotum. We know that they are enclosed by scrotum. So testis are suspended in the scrotum by cords. Okay? These cords are called spermatic cords. What are they called? Spermatic cords. So what is the function of spermatic cords? The testis, they are suspended in the scrotum by these cords, which are known as the spermatic cords. The outermost covering of testis is formed by a dense membrane which is called tunica albuginea. So, what is tunica albuginea? The outermost covering of testis. This is formed by a fibrous membrane. So, that fibrous membrane which forms the outermost covering of testis is called tunica albuginea. Each testis is again divided into 200 to 300 compartments, which are known as testicular lobules. So those 200 to 300 compartments in the testis is what we call as testicular lobules. Now let's go and study about lobule. Each lobule, it again contains 1 to 3 highly convoluted, what we call as seminiferous tubules. It also contains blood vessels and it is embedded in the connective tissue, loose connective tissue. What we said is each testis is divided into compartments. How many compartments? 200 to 300. These compartments are called testicular lobules. Each lobule now further contains 1 to 3 highly convoluted seminiferous tubules. It also contains blood vessels, and both the tubules and the blood vessels, they are enclosed in loose connective tissue. Moving on to the second organ, that is scrotum. What is it? Scrotum. It is a pouch-like structure. It arises from the lower abdominal wall. This pouch-like structure, scrotum, where does it arise from? It arises from the lower abdominal wall. Its main function is it keeps the temperature of the testis about 2 to 2.5 degrees Celsius lower than the internal body temperature. Why is this lowering of body temperature needed? for production of sperms. Remember, temperature around 2 to 2.5 degrees Celsius is less than the internal body temperature, which is very important for the production of sperms. Now, scrotum is further divided into right and left sacs, right scrotal sac and left scrotal sac. So, it is further divided into two sections, right and left. Each of them are called scrotal sacs, SSCS. So, right scrotal sac and left scrotal sac. Both these sacs, the right and the left, they are separated by a partition. It's a muscular partition, which is known as septum scrota. What is this partition between the left and the right scrotal sac called as? It's a muscular partition. It is known as septum scrota. The testes, they originate in the abdominal cavity. See, the origination is actually in the abdominal cavity. But later, somewhere around the 7th month of development, they descend into the scrotal sacs. So, they don't originate in the scrotal sacs. They originate where? They originate in the abdominal cavity. It is around the 7th month of the development that they descend into the sacs through a passage. This passage is known as inguinal canal. I-N-G-U-I-N-A-L. Inguinal canal. Look at the spelling. I-N-G-U-I-N-A-L. Inguinal canal. So, it is through this inguinal canal, it is through this passage that in the 7th month of development, the testes, they descend into the scrotum from the abdominal cavity. Moving on to the third and the last primary organ, that is seminiferous tubules. See, Veda, these seminiferous tubules, they are structural and functional unit of testes. Here, actually the sperms are produced. Each tubule is lined on the inside by two types of cells. Each tubule from inside, it is lined by two types of cells, Sertoli cells or germ cells. We also call Sertoli cells as nurse cells. We'll come to know why. But as of now, just remember that inside we have two types of cells, Sertoli cells and germ cells. The majority of the cells are germ cells. Very few are Sertoli cells. The majority of the internal cells are actually germ cells. These germ cells, they produce spermatogonia by mitotic division. These germ cells undergo mitotic division and they produce spermatogonia. By which division? Mitotic division. These spermatogonia further grow to become primary spermatocytes. So, primary spermatogonia are becoming primary spermatocytes. These primary spermatocytes will undergo meiosis now. Remember, earlier we had mitosis. We had what? We had spermatogonia were produced by mitotic division. These spermatogonia, they grow and they become primary spermatocytes. These spermatocytes then undergo meiosis and they produce haploid cells. These haploid cells which are produced from primary spermatocytes are called secondary spermatocytes. Is it okay? And then later spermatids. Fine. Moving on to the other type of cells, that is Sertoli cells. They are tall cuboidal shaped cells. They give nutrition to the developing germ cells. So when a germ cell is developing, who is going to give nutrition? These Sertoli cells. The region inside the tubule is called interstitial space. The region inside the seminiferous tubule, it is called interstitial space, I-N-T-E-R-S-T-I-T-I-A-L, interstitial space. This space inside the tubule, which is known as interstitial space, it contains blood vessels and it also contains mass of cells. So basically in this space inside, that is the interstitial square space, you have two things. You have blood vessels and you also have mass of cells. This mass of cells is called as interstitial cells. What are these cells called? Interstitial cells, or commonly we call them as Leydig cells. L-E-Y-D-I-G, Leydig cells. These Leydig cells or interstitial cells, they secrete hormones which are called as androgens. So androgens are secreted by Leydig cells or interstitial cells. These Leydig cells are endocrine in function. Remember, they are endocrine in function. So they regulate and they maintain the male sex characteristics. Because they are endocrine in function, so they keep on regulating and maintaining the male sex characteristics. That is all we have done. We have done about testes, we have done about scrotum, and we have done about seminiferous tubules. Thank you.